is Rose, and we are still working on our kitchen cabinetry that we are stripping because the old varnish and stain that was on there was flaking off, and so it's not a suitable piece to do gel stain on. So I'm using citrus gel because it's the safest one to use indoors, but it's not fast. And so I'm going to show you a little bit more detail of how we are doing it. This little strip right in here, if you can see this piece right here and here, and there's little bits on the edges that were still left from we couldn't get off with our power sander. So I'm taking my little, well, I don't know what this is called. There's a wire bristles, and it's a stripping brush, and it's very effective. And I've got a bucket of water, and I just dip it in there and go. You just go and scrub and scrub and scrub. And it takes it off. You gotta use a lot of elbow grease. You don't want to have this stuff falling on your feet because it stings, burns your skin. So I've got sandals on, so I got to step back. So I'm making sure that it's not going to drip on me. But like as you can see, it takes quite a bit of elbow grease to get this layer off. Eventually, it comes. If you move to your next area. What I do when I'm all done, because like especially in this area, you get kind of a soupy mix by the time you're finished. And so I just keep dipping it in there because it gets so gummy on your brush that it won't even work anymore. So I dip it in the water, do a little bit more brushing. You see it's starting to get really gummy on the brush. And then once I've got a pretty good soupy mix here, I just take this paper towel, get as much as I can so I don't have a lot of drippage, you know, on me or on the floor. And then I continue to work. When we're all done, we're gonna take acetone and our little scrub brush again and clean off all the debris. Then it will be ready for stain. Bye.